Good evening. It's meant to be a secure, trusted process, but a major bungle has meant HSC results, supposed to come out next week, have now been accessed by potentially tens of thousands of students. The Education Minister has apologised and a full investigation is now underway.
Blaxland High School's Sophie Chapman is a high-achieving student with dreams of studying medicine. Today, those aspirations seemed a step closer as she gained access to her HSC results 5 days earlier than expected.
I got so flustered and panicked that I couldn't even type out a message to say to my friends, this is real.
A so-called IT glitch, today enabling school leavers to log on to their students' online account, revealing subject marks that were supposed to be released on Thursday.
You expect that it's going to be released on this one day that has been built up for the whole year, and then all of a sudden, on a random Saturday morning, here we are.
And you have to take this set of data and then go and put it into an ATAR calculator.
That's your immediate thought.
That actually is quite dangerous because the ATAR might end up being completely different because of the scaling. That is going to cause a lot of anxiety.
Students started to access the results from as early as 1 this morning. The URL going viral on the HSC Facebook discussion group with more than 32,000 members. That's nearly half of the state's class of 2022. The site was eventually shut down more than 9 hours later at 10:30 a.m. meaning thousands of students like Fleur Davies missed out.
Shocked that I couldn't log on in time, scared for the next 7 days because some of my friends got really good results and I'm just waiting in the dark.
The government, just as much in the dark, today demanding answers.
We just apologise for the confusion or the distress that this may have caused, and I've made it clear to Nessa that I'm not happy about what's happened. I want a full explanation.
The click frenzy sending the state's Education Standards Authority into a scramble.
We should know by during the week what exactly happened in that period or that window of time, and then we'll make sure that we can put into place safeguards for 2023.
Madison Scott, 9 News.